So there's massive wins to be had with healthier, happier people whose, you know, sexy time is more fun, and they're not just dying and rotting and even forgetting who their friends are and who their family are. You know,
I guess the argument would be overpopulation, though, against that. Just to take the other side of that.
I'll give you all the arguments. Dictators live forever. No, they won't. They die all the time. It's a very dangerous job. Only the rich people have it. No, they won't. Cell phones, computers, rich people had to have them first. Now look, all the plebs have exactly the same quality. Your phone and your computer are just as good as Bill Gates, probably better to tell you the truth. You see him in a video, his stuff sucks. What else? Overpopulation, where? Negative population growth in Europe, negative population growth in Japan. There's negative population growth all over the place.
But assuming you were successful, or the Sense Foundation was successful, rather, in lengthening lives.
People will just screw less.
Just how destructive we are.
We're not destructive at all. Who do you think is going to say we're not destructive at all?
You don't think 90, so?
I'm going to prove it to you. 99.9% of any living thing that has ever existed is permanently extinct. Every once in a while, an asteroid comes and kills everything. And who do you think the only species on this planet is that can save everything else? It's us. It's the humans. We need to catch the asteroids early and shift them off their path, or everything on this planet will die again. So when I hear stories about us destroying the planet, in fact, we are the only people that can save it. Matter of fact, we're so important that we even generated the concept of importance. And if we die, importance dies with us. The very idea that something matters dies with us.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we matter a lot. And this,
not that we don't. Absolutely. Yeah. I totally agree.
If you're looking at like the overcrowding thing, get an airplane. It's empty everywhere. The only places it's not totally empty are where people want to stack on top of each other because the restaurants are better. That's it. There's no forced overcrowding anywhere, man. There's not.
It doesn't really last. Like Kowloon Walled City. That was super interesting watching documentaries about 700,000 people, like basically per block equivalently. Like it was insane. It was super cool looking. Wish I could have gone to that. But yeah, I mean, people were happy to live there. It also kind of went away. Nothing lasts forever. That's the one thing I do know. But it would be nice to have a better.
Think about all the energy in this universe that we live in. Is it not there for us to utilize? If you're a religious person and you're not allowed to commit suicide and God gives you the tools to save your own life and you choose not to use them, aren't you kind of committing suicide? Shouldn't you use those tools he gave you? Because the game didn't have to be this way. The game didn't have to be the way where you could improve yourself and improve your fellow man, but it is that way. And so I feel it's our obligation to do it.